I went on Shlichus in 1974. I got a survey from the Rebbe for about a lot of different towns in upstate New York. I should write what's the matzav of Yidden there, how many Yidden there are, if they have a shul, if they have a mikveh, all these things. And when I reported all that, so I got a hira from Rabbi Charikov to build a mikveh in Troy.
Dorten wird gelegt der Jesod durch die Ruhe, was mit Beutus auf der Linie von der Mikvitare aufzuziehen. Bechol ich fand im Hofschorium, er soll sein der Kiyum Mitzvah zu, mit der Simcha auf Tuv Levov.
Now Troy really, certainly at that time, was a declining population. There weren't young people moving into there. And it didn't really seem like they needed a mikveh. A mikveh is a big expense. And I could barely pay my living expenses, and there is a mikveh in Albany. And to undertake a mikveh in Troy sounded very unrealistic. When I wasn't commenting on progress, the Rebbe, I got it settled, Ma'im HaMikveh, like what's doing with the mikveh. And the Rebbe said that he will give the last third of the cost. And we pushed ahead about it, and we had it built. There are a number of people who had children as a result, who had difficulty with children, and they had brachas that they used the mikveh.
Is a yedu as the Rebbe der Bala Giulo is a vegi hot nem farshikt in a zwei stot kastrama und die Union was dort misaken gewe was dort gelernt und gedauert und gegeben zu dort und getan kamen wir kamen mit sich. Und das aber, was sie gewähnt, verbunden mit dem Mord. Und mit den Jiden, was in jenem Mord, wo uns lieb der Ruf in die Gewänke in andere Weg, seit er soll dahin zu kommen, ist das gewähnt auch der Ingen von dort mit Aufstehung der Minion am Mikwe, er soll sein, wie es darf zu sein, er soll geboren werden, koschere jüdische Kinder.
I was in Japan on business, and my father-in-law must have mentioned to the Rebbe that I was in Tokyo and that I would be there for Shabbos. I had a phone call at my hotel from Rabbi Beryl Levy of the OK. He said, I'm in the Philippines on Hashgacha matters. The Rebbe asked that I call you. He knows you're in Tokyo. And he said, Min Stam and Shabbos, you'll go to the Tokyo Jewish community. And the Rebbe is very concerned that they are planning on building a new shul. And there is some disagreement among the people as to whether they're going to include a mikveh in the new building. The Rebbe said, Min Stamen, while you're there, you'll give tzedakah. And the Rebbe said he wants to be shutvis with you in your tzedakah. And the Rebbe asked that if you would make clear that the tzedakah is for the new mikveh, and if you could write a letter to the members of the kehillah about the importance of mikveh, and that you are making a contribution in your name in partners with the Lubavitcher Rebbe.
You know, Uncle Max Schreiber, or Shalom, is to build a mikvah in Eretz Yisrael. Schreiber?
Yeah,
right. So I'm his nephew, David Schreiber.
Since he passed away,
yes.
There is no one that has taken his place.
That's true.
Then you are recording.
I built a mikvah in Woodmere.
He was not satisfied about your own mikveh. was much more. Right. Then the trial, at least the first 10
First time that ever says.
Okay. Yes, I'm going to much bless you.
Okay.
$10 for the 10 meters. Oh, that's low. Okay. It is not enough to cover all the cover of the expenses of the mikveh, and the rest will depend. Brocha v'atzlocha.
Rabbi Binyamin Klein called me up. The Rebbe said the inyan of a mikveh in Long Beach is very important. I have instructed to send you a check of $1,000 special delivery, Oscar Alatzin. Now, in Long Beach, California, in 1973, mikveh was not a household word, but Reb Moshe Yosef Engel, who worked hard as a teacher, he threw himself into it, heart and soul.
We brought in consultants, and we built up a beautiful mikveh, not knowing why and for who. At the open house, a lady that at that time was not observant at all wrote a letter to the Jewish newspaper. I walked into this open house of the mikveh. There were 140 people. It looked like a spa. They explained what mikveh was all about. It's such a beautiful idea. And she challenged the Jewish community to go and see the mikveh.
We got calls from different places. Can we see your blueprints, how you build a mikveh? And we made 50 copies, and we figured this is going to last forever. We had to make more copies to send it out to different mikvahs.
We started getting calls and letters from everywhere you can dream of. We sent out a package to all over America, and it said how to do it, how we did it, how we're going around publicizing it.
Rebbe's vision was once again proven to be spot on, as they say.
It literally created a revival of mikvahs throughout America.
Thank you very much for bringing an additional mikvah.
Amen.